What?
Were you sitting?
I was.
Hello, Mr.
Yeah. Whatever you prefer. Okay, so Lyndsie, and sorry, your last name?
Barrie.
Barrie, okay. I think that's all written on here anyway. Okay, so can you talk a little bit about kind of how things got started? I know both the other ladies touched on it, but can I hear it from your perspective?
Yeah, for sure. So I started my own financial consulting business in 2014 after being fired from a job working for a really big investment company. I wasn't producing enough commissions. I had a real hard time with the sales role that I was in versus wanting to more educate people.
Okay.
And so I was, you know, the universe kind of, you know, yanked the rug out from under me, and I had to start my own business. And through learning how to market my own business, I realized, as I, you know, made friends with more women trying to do it, that I knew things that they didn't because of trial and error and hiring my own business coach and various things. So one of the things I did quite quickly on was I wrote a book for moms about money management and investing, just to teach them a lot of the stuff that we all probably should have learned in high school.
For sure.
And so all of that just taught me a lot of cool stuff about marketing. I got more and more comfortable on social media. I started sharing the story about getting fired, sharing the story about, you know, being a hairdresser and learning how to talk to people from that, and then taking that into the world of finance and all those things that I was nervous to share at first, because I thought it would discredit me.
Okay.
I just became more vulnerable about it. And as I learned how to do that, I realized that the key was having women around me that were lifting me up and encouraging me, and like seeing something I posted on social media and saying, that really impacted me, and I felt, you know, uplifted by that, or I learned something from you, or, you know, those kind of things. So I wanted to create that atmosphere for more women, but I made a couple attempts at it. I didn't really know how to make a community that would continue past the education.
Right. Okay.
So finally, a year and a bit ago, I was given the gift of something called the Hoffman process. I was one of 26 people that went and experienced a week of like intensive group therapy.
Wow.
It was amazing. And, you know, the giver just said, you know, give back, like do something awesome like this for others. That's all I want in return. And I was like, had this clear vision of this community while I was there. I finally realized how I could make it continue. So quickly after coming back from the Hoffman process in November 2018, I launched this in January with the first free 6-week marketing school. My sixth class starts tomorrow morning, actually. So 10 new women are going to go through the program.
Wow.
And the book just felt so natural. Like I started writing it on my birthday in August, and it was completed 3 weeks ago.
Okay.
And it just like flowed out of me because I had the material. I had all the feedback from the girls being like, this is valuable. This is helpful. Make sure this is in the book. These two and five other women actually would like jump on 6 a.m. Zoom calls with me and read the material I was writing and give me feedback on it. So like if they wouldn't have helped me, I wouldn't have had the book done. I wouldn't have had it done so quickly.
Right.
Like, and having them contribute their stories is just incredible. So, and to be a part of this community, Cochrane has always supported me. Like from the moment I started my business with a financial company, I was knocking on doors, brand new to town. I just moved here. And like this community has always really supported me. So I wanted to do something to give back. And so the free marketing school just is, it's awesome. And I'm so like happy to have these girls say that it's been valuable for them.
Yeah,
too.
Well, it sounds really amazing. So how do people kind of get hooked up with this free marketing school?
Yeah, so they just go to yyzfempreneur.com and they can register. The next class starts April 8th.
Okay.
And by the end of the year, I personally will have taught 100 women.
Wow.
And another goal of the book is kind of like a leader guide. So it teaches the 6 fundamental strategies and concepts that are part of the free marketing school. But the number one thing, none of it works if you don't have a team. So that's what the book teaches in the first chapter, two chapters is, how do you build a team around you? And then what do you do with that team? And then it's all laid out for them. So it's kind of like a book slash leader guide.
Yeah.
And yeah, so.
So who would this course be good for? Is it just people who have a business, or could it be for someone else too?
Well, one of the girls, one of my book project team members, her name is Cynthia, and she came in. She's a retired RCMP officer. She had a speaking gig coming up for the suicide awareness conference in Calgary. And she was just like, I know I need to get out on social media more. I have this, like all these stories and this message, but so she didn't have like a business in mind. She didn't see herself as a businesswoman, and she took a ton away from it.
Okay.
And she, you know, has now created this like online mental health hub, and she's, you know, impacting people. She's writing a book as well. She had already started writing her book before, but the school really draws, like Kelly and Carrie said, it really draws that message out of the women. They're like, it's in there, but they can't really pinpoint it.
Right.
And they've so, and it's like, you know, like, oh, I have all these ideas and all these passions. And it's like, how do I, and you, you know, if you go on social media with a million different messages, it's like confusing.
It's too right? much. Yeah. I'm sure a lot of people just struggle with where do you start? What's kind of step one?
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, exactly. And so right. once step one becomes the team, everything else falls into place.
Yeah.
Because now they have feedback and, like Carrie said, no cattiness. It's always community and support and collaboration. And there's like no competition. And I came from the world of hairdressing and like I couldn't believe that a group of women could come together and actually support each other
yeah.
and get along, because that was not my experience when I was 20 and working in a salon. So
that must be really refreshing.
It's so refreshing. Yeah. Yeah. yeah.
So do you meet in Cochrane then too as a group, like outside of the course?
Yeah. So we do 6 sessions on Zoom at 6 a.m. 6 to 7 a.m. works well for the moms. And it's like, we probably have some girls who would love to join and won't because of the time, but you know what I
yeah.
mean? The goal of the book, of course, is to have other people teaching the school as well. So hopefully they'll do different times. But my time that I teach is always 6 to 7 a.m.
Yeah.
And then we do usually midway through, we try to do some sort of a group event where we all come together in somebody's house usually
okay.
and do like a potluck and like just get together and meet face to face. And then absolutely every time at the end, we do a big celebration and I get like some merch, like some like swag, like whatever, give some stuff away, do prizes. And we did the first couple up before they closed down up in Sunset, and we did the last two at Half Hitch.
Okay.
And Half Hitch is probably going to be kind of our home for grad night going on, because it works
okay
well.
For grad night. Nice. So okay, so the book is launching here, you know, in just 2 weeks or so, less than 2 weeks.
Yeah.
And there's going to be a big launch party. So who can come to this?
Anyone can come to it, you know, but if you're a woman in Cochrane or Calgary and you want to meet more women like you who are trying to get your message on social media, trying to, like Carrie said, make a positive impact on the world, it's going to be just a really great gathering of those kind of women. I'm going to have each of my book team members stand up and tell their little, like a brief version of
okay.
the story that's
yeah.
in the book and introduce themselves to the group. So it's going to be a great place to connect, not network, but connect.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. And it's a physical book, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So
yeah.
it's not just an online, you know,
no.
with your e-reader. It's a physical
yeah.
book. So where can people buy the book?
Well, right now, you need to go to every Chapters and Indigo store in Calgary and ask them for the book, because
okay.
that's how they will actually put the book on their shelves.
Okay.
My previous book was on the shelf at Indigo Signal Hill for 3 years. They just pulled it because it's getting older. So good time to maybe get another book on
get
the shelf there.
Yeah.
But they can buy it. They can buy it at yycfempreneur.com.
Okay.
And as it becomes available in more bookstores, yeah, it's on Amazon too. You can always order it on Amazon.
Okay.
And
okay.
you can get the ebook on Amazon
right.
too.
Right. Okay.
Yeah.
Maybe there's some opportunity for some of the local businesses
yeah.
to sell it.
Yeah,
so,
yeah, that'd be great.
Yeah. I think that's all I wanted to ask. I think this sounds like a really, you know, just I love the concept of it all. Anything else you'd like to mention?
You know, to the man who sent me to Hoffman and a lot of other people, like, thank you. He might make an appearance at the book launch party.
Okay.
And yeah, he's a pretty incredible guy doing a lot of cool things in Calgary and beyond. And I'm like, you know, I'm kind of a success story of his goodwill. So I just wanted to thank him publicly. He knows who he is. And a lot of people know who he is, but I'm not allowed to say his name. So.
Okay.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Well, thank you.
Thank
I appreciate
you.
That.
That was fun.
Yeah.
Except for like my voice started getting all crazy at the end.
That
I should have
so
done a warm up.
No,
yeah, exactly.
Got the thing struck.
Do you do vocal warm ups in the morning before you get on the radio?
Like sometimes when I have a cold or something, I try to, as I'm driving into work, I'll crank the tunes and try to sing
along.
It makes a difference.